I always had one problem with puzzle games, and that's the fact that they're only fun in like short spurts. I can enjoy some Tetris to kill some time while waiting for something, and a little bit of Columns or Bejeweled or what have you. That's really great once in a while. But really, unless you're a gamer that really, really loves puzzle games, I mean they're not the type of games that keep you coming. They'll keeps you makes you keep coming back to. You don't play them for hours, and once you play them, you play them really casually. They're really, really casual games, and that's really one of the reasons why I really am not hooked on that genre, the puzzle games. When you're bored and you have nothing else to do, these games are just fun distractions, but they're nothing more than that. A puzzle lover would of course be playing these games for hours on end, but without any real motivation behind the puzzles, I think for regular gamers, they're fun for like 30 minutes or so at a time, and once or twice is enough to be satisfied with the game, and never pick up the game in a long time after that. So I heard a lot of great things about Luminous for the PlayStation Portable, and I was hoping that this problem with the puzzle genre would be solved with this game for me. I think one of the reasons why Luminous is so highly sought after also is because of it has the original firmware update for PSP. So it has, if you want to downgrade your PSP firmware, you get Luminous and you install this, and you're back to version like 1.1, which is version 1. So you can do homebrew on your PSP or something. I don't really care about homebrew, so that was totally not the reason why I got Luminous. I just got it because it looked like a really great puzzle game. But unfortunately, Luminous is like every other puzzle game to me, and it has the same problem. Unless you're a die-hard puzzle fan, Luminous is a game that you probably should overlook. Luminous is an awesome game for puzzle fans, but it won't really convert anyone to start liking puzzle games. That said, I will tell you that as a puzzle game, Luminous is a blast to play, and incredibly challenging. The mechanics of the game are so simple and easy to pick up, but a little bit more into the game and you'll realize that this isn't just a simple game like Tetris or Columns or Bejeweled. It's not a game where you're just mindlessly, fitting blocks or fitting colors or matching colors or what have you. This game really has you on your balls. Trying to match the color of four blocks has never been so satisfying and so challenging. The fact is really odd, especially in considering that there's only two different colors to worry about, and the only shape that you're given is a square of the block. You don't have to mess around with this shape of Tetris blocks or the zigzag or whatever. It's just squares. You just get four block squares with two different colors to worry about. That's it. It's really simple, but it's actually much more challenging than Tetris. So the reason is because the incredible amount of depth and challenge it shows is really what makes this game shine. It's what makes this amazing puzzle game. The thing is, you have to match the blocks in accordance with the sweeping line that moves from left side of the screen to the right side of the screen. As the music plays and the line sweeps across, anything the line touches that are matching in color, the line eliminates and gives you points. If you match blocks too soon or too late, you'll have missed the good elimination combos that would earn you more points and, more importantly, more empty space. So it's really all about not just about matching the shapes or matching the colors. It's also about timing. I don't really think timing has a lot to do with the music that's being played, although it kind of feels like it. But timing it with that sweeping line is very, very important. And you'll find out for this factor is it's also what makes it a challenging feature when you go into like a challenge mode or puzzle mode. A puzzle mode is insane. You have to make the blocks into a shape that is on the screen, and to get that shape, I mean, it's really, really difficult. But it's what makes it a puzzle game. You want to match the shape of the puzzle. I mean, I keep mentioning this because the first level is a cross that floats in midair. So what you have to do is you have to stack it all up, eliminate the bottom ones, and just for that one split second, have all the have the sweeping line eliminate the blocks right there that makes the cross stand. It's really challenging, it's really, really fun. But the thing is. The thing that makes this game not have longevity is that there is no checkpoint with levels. So you in challenge mode, you know, you get more rewards. The better you do, the more skins you get, the more kind of the more music you earn and stuff like that. But the thing is, you progress in the challenge mode. You get to like level 7 or something, and you get a game over. And you start the game again, you're gonna have to start from level 1. You know, that's one thing. Like, there is no like continue. You know, you can't continue the game. You can't select the level. So you kind of have to repeat it again. But it's a really fun game that you might want to keep repeating. It's really innovative and challenging. But at the end of the day, just like all the other casual puzzle games, it just lacks that staying power. You know, it's very novel. It's very innovative. It's really challenging. It really feels like a puzzle game and not just like match the shapes or match the colors. And it has timing involved too. So it's a music game as well. It's a rhythm puzzle game. But you know, you can only play it so much. You know, after playing about like 4 or 5 times, you know, you're pretty much done unless you become really, really addicted to the puzzle mode. I stopped with the puzzle mode. It just got too hard for me after a while. I was just like, I can't figure this out. I'm just gonna give up. So, you know, if you get really into that, that's gonna have a lot of longevity. But other than that, it's really like other puzzle games in that it just doesn't have that staying power. But it's a really, really fun game.